Of course, we compensate hunters for their contributions. So, make sure to check out any other notice boards you come across. They're usually near outposts. Thanks to this system, hunters can help keep this place in tip-top shape, and they get to choose when and how they help out. One last thing. I suggest you go to the nearest lookout tower. It's north of your current location. It'll help you orient yourself and give you a good overview over the valley. I gotta say, your reputation precedes you. I was thrilled when I saw your name among the applicants for this year's competition. There's this other warden who only had good things to say about your ethics and expertise. Since I trust his judgment 100%, I trust you too. Which reminds me, I have a surprise guest for you. An old friend of yours. You'll find out soon enough, I promise. He should be on his way here right now. Once he's arrived, I'll get you two reacquainted. This valley is an amazing all-round hunting area, both for new and pro hunters. Rivers, lakes, uplands, forests, mountains. There's lots of different biomes and all kinds of game. Pro tip, if you need to get your bearings, try to find lookouts when you're out exploring. They're scattered all across the reserve. I can't wait to introduce you to my little slice of paradise. And I can only encourage you to wander off and discover the reserve on your own. If you're good to go, I have a mission of the utmost importance for you. I need someone I can trust to collect maple syrup. You heard me right. Maple syrup. Should you choose to accept this mission, I shall share my best-kept secret with you. My favorite maple syrup spot. More details will be shared with you in due course. Your objective? An area located near the river flowing east to west, right between the mountain ranges. I've marked it on your hunter mate. Godspeed. I'm sure you think it's weird that I'm asking you to pick up maple syrup. I know. Talk about New England cliche. While we're on the topic of cliches, did you know the white-tailed deer is one of New Hampshire's living insignia? It's also one of our most popular species among hunters. So, if you like hunting white-tailed deer, feel free to take part in our challenge. Can't wait to see you in action. I've been walking in wilderness as long as I can remember. Me and my father, we basically lived outdoors. I'd get to know every species, every specimen, learn what they eat, where they sleep, how they feel. At the end of the day, you gotta respect all creatures, especially the ones you hunt. The first time I came here, I was 19. I worked here as a seasonal ranger one summer, and I just fell in love with the place. I was lucky they offered me a full-time job as a ranger. Flash forward 20 years, and I'm head warden. Funny how life can be sometimes. I'm originally from the Pacific Northwest. I was born and raised in the Layton Lake District Reserve. Rings a bell? Yep, exactly. That same reserve you visited back then. This probably gives you a big clue as to who my surprise guest is. Fair warning, though. He can be a little gruff and reserved. Unless you get him started on black bears or unethical hunters, then he won't shut up. His name? Carlton Locke, a.k.a. my old man. Everyone always calls him Doc, even my mom. I never understood why. Oh, you're there. Great job, Agent. Our teams have a nickname for that location, the Maple Spot. I realize this might be dangerous, but your next mission is to collect the maple syrup buckets. You'll spot them easily. They're metal buckets hanging on maple trees. Good luck out there. Thank you. Know that I appreciate your efforts. There's one last thing we need to... Sorry, I can't keep a straight face anymore. Here's the reason. We're preparing souvenirs for all participants as a thank you for all their contributions to supporting the reserve. That way, everyone goes home with a little taste of New England. That's all. If you don't mind, could you drop it off at the nearest outpost? Let me see. Okay, there's one in that valley. Just follow the river west. You would really be doing me a solid. By the way, I have another very important request for you. Hikers have reported spotting wood devils in the reserve lately. Which is strange, because no one in this area has seen one for years. There used to be a lot more of them in these forests, I heard. They're quite elusive, so only an expert tracker like you might be able to spot one. If you do, make sure you take a photo. I'll need it for my next video. I count on you. Hey, I realize I barely gave you any info on wood devils earlier. My bad. Well, they're almost extinct, unfortunately. They're mammals, slender build, gray fur. Thing is, they're tough to spot, even when you're close to them. They're extremely nimble, and they tend to hide behind trees when spooked. So you want to focus your search mainly in wooded areas. Hope this helps. One of many uniquely shaped granite boulders you'll find in New England. People like finding shapes in clouds. Out here, we like finding animals in geological formations. Thanks a lot. I'll have Holly pick them up when she's back from Nashua. Sorry, I don't usually ask visitors to help with regular warden tasks, but we're short-staffed this week. All right. There's one last thing that you need to know about wood devils. One of their main characteristics, in fact. They're utterly and totally made up. It's a small prank we like to play on newcomers. I make sure to come clean after a short while, though. Don't want to waste anyone's time. It's basically the New England version of the Sasquatch or Bigfoot. Some people claim they saw one, especially in the 19th and 20th centuries, but there hasn't been any scientific evidence. There's always a small chance it could be an undiscovered species, but it's pretty unlikely if you ask me. Many of our visitors love local myths and folklore, and so do I. It's a great way to share cool stories about my second home.
Hello, is this thing working? Can you hear me? Doc here. How are things, old friend? My son Trevor told you I was visiting, right? Haven't been here in years. Last time, Trev was so proud to show me around, and we found some peaceful remote spots we loved. Sorry, I don't remember where they are exactly. We took a few photos back then, and I sent them in the mail a few days ago. I think Trev left the pictures at an outpost for you, in case you'd like to check out those spots for yourself.